Fucking hell.
How was that, that march then, newbie?
Oh, not too bad, not too bad. It's alright.
Oh, they'll get harder, mark my words.
Yeah, sure they will.
I'm just glad order's been restored to the land after Jesus was crucified on Friday.
Yeah, an absolute menace. We just couldn't have him knocking round for some reason.
Was it because he represented an authority figure that wasn't concurrent with your current belief system, so you paid his best friend to stab him in the back?
Yeah,
is that it?
Yeah.
Hit nail on that.
I think so.
You're Brutus, right?
That's right, I'm gonna wear it out.
Yeah. So you're trying to get that conversion on your house, aren't you?
With the fifth kid, being in the army is a constant struggle. Sending money home to care for the family when every day my life is on the line, it's a risk. Yeah, what about it?
Well, there's gold just lying around, if you want it.
What?
You know, help.
That's a lot of money.
Who gave you this?
Oh, an old man.
Like your dad?
Oh no, not my old man. An old man.
Oh.
And you're Julius, yeah?
Yeah.
You're the one whose mum's ill.
Yeah, got the old polypsis she has. Why do you...
Well, I've got a balm here that cures polyps, if you want it, free of charge.
Oh, really? Thank you. How did you get hold of that?
Well, I had some frankincense and myrrh lying around, so I thought I'd make some, you know, whip some up.
Oh, wow, that's helpful.
Cheers, man. Wow. That's a funny mark on your hand there.
Oh, yeah. I had an accident with some nails. Made me quite cross, that one. Yeah.
Sounds painful. You managed to do it with both your hands.
Yeah, yeah. I guess I'm just clumsy, I guess. Pricks!
And your feet.
Oh, those are just blisters from the march, I'm sure. Anyway, I gotta shoot, so I'll see you guys later.
All right.
See ya.
Wait a minute.
You don't think?
Gold.
Frankincense.
Myrrh.
Nah.
We killed him.
Stuck him up on a cross the other week.
The Lord has returned!
Jesus!
Jesus! He's back! He's back!
Bitches!
He's top lad, though.
What a nice guy.
Praise the Christ.
It's a lovely meal you've prepared for us, darling.
Oh, thank you, love.
Shall we say grace?
Can I say grace, Mummy?
Oh, of course you can, Michael.
But I wanted to say grace, Daddy.
Lawrence, why can't we say one part of grace each?
Okay, Daddy.
Blessed be the Instagram gods that allow us to take a photo and upload it to our Instagrams for our followers to feast our eyes upon.
And praise to the Lord who gave us his food and drink and who made us pin it on Pinterest.
Good food, good meat, good Lord. Let's tweet.
Do it properly, Jeremy!
Okay. Blessed be this food and allow us to post it on Tumblr as 6x4 gift sets or text posts with chain replies. Blessed be the eternal Tumblr god. Amen.
Thank you, much better. Bless us our Lord and your gifts of which we are about to Snapchat from our phones. In social media, we are vain. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, fucking hell, it's you again.
Me?
Yes, you difficult bastard.
Why are you being so offensive? I just got here.
Oh my god, you forget every time. He really needs to fix that. Alright, do you know where you are?
No.
You're in purgatory! Yay! You get to be reincarnated as whatever kind of life you want.
What? Really? That's great!
Yeah.
Oh. I want to be
a mayfly!
What?
Yep. You've been here 4 billion times, and every sodding time, you choose a fucking mayfly.
I mean, who wouldn't want to be a mayfly?
Literally anyone.
All right, hear me out. Okay, you just get to mill about, eat some leaves, shag some mayflies, you know, repeat.
Yes, but for 2 days. I mean, is it really worth it?
I mean, what can happen in 2 days?
I mean, aren't you bored of it? You've chosen it 4 billion times.
Well, you know, there's always some new leaves to eat and some new mayflies to shag. So,
yeah, but for 2 days.
Oh, supposedly I come back here and choose a mayfly again. So technically speaking, there are infinite number of days of me slaying Ephraimata pussy.
I mean... I mean, slaying pussy, I get.
Depends what type of leaves you're doing, if you get me.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Alright then, so would you like me to be down as a mayfly again?
I mean, I'm kind of having second thoughts now, but. What else have you got?
Okay, so we've got a giraffe.
I'm scared of heights.
French bulldog.
Wild mac cheese.
A Japanese fighting fish.
I don't speak the language.
A dragonfly?
Wankers.
Well, the celebrities are quite a popular choice. We could have a look through the list if you want.
Yeah.
So
sure.
We've got Daniel Craig, Chris Pratt. Piers Morgan?
Nah, I don't want the downgrade.
That's fine. Well, why don't you have a quick look at some of the job roles and we'll see what you got.
Californian porn star, mate.
A Californian porn star?
Yeah.
But I thought you wanted to slay puss and eat leaves. I get you now. Alright, then I'll put you in the system there, but you know, give her one for me.
You fucking weirdo.
It's happening again. And nothing can stop it.
Any updates? I'm afraid they've done it. They've got the planning permission.
Prepare to take the residential world by storm.
The city will never be seen again.
They're meant to be from Liverpool, by the way. Drain your credit card, spend your student loans.
It's planned to be double the size per square meter, all accommodation. Where will the people shop?
Written, Irish
written by Mayor Jo Anderson, directed by Mayor Jo Anderson, and starring Mayor Jo Anderson.
My master plan for the city! We've also announced the youth! How can we attract the youth to the city without student accommodation?
The city's already 95% student accommodation, with the other 5% being grants and Poundland!
From the creators of Liverpool 1, Liverpool 2!
Troopers, you have been selected to participate in this focus group. As you know, the Galactic Empire is building a giant planet-destroying space superweapon, and Lord Vader has tasked me with finding out exactly what it is the average stormtrooper wants to see in such a weapon. My first question, what should it be called? We've already been pooling a few suggestions together for this. What do you think of Death Star or Doom Moon?
Doom Moon sounds good. Yeah, Death Star's a little on the nose.
Death Star's scary.
I mean, how are you going to persuade the galactic taxpayer that something called a Death Star is worth funding?
To be honest, Doom Moon isn't exactly like the least intimidating name either.
Perhaps we should call it something that doesn't reveal what it is, like Imperial Recreation Center with a free bar. That way the rebels won't know what's happening until it's too late.
No, the Emperor specifically wants his battle station to be terrifying. Fear will keep the rebellion under control.
I mean, you could go one further. Call it something like Starkiller Base.
Shut up, Gerald. My next question, what colour should it be?
Oh, blue, or green, or turquoise.
I mean, if you wanted to scare the rebels, shouldn't it be the colour of something scary? Maybe black, like Lord Vader's helmet?
Don't be stupid, space is black. Like a black battle station out in space, it'll blend in against the background, you won't be able to find it.
Oh.
Maybe like really, really dark grey. Well, that's almost black.
I mean, dark grey's alright. I mean, I think blue would be better, but yeah, sure.
Very well. Grey it is. We've also been having some thoughts about the shape. Now, what do you think about it being spherical?
Why spherical? Surely if it's called Death Star, it should be more star-shaped. Otherwise, it's more of a death ball.
Well, Empire's never been the most accurate organization when it comes to names, has it? Star Destroyers don't destroy stars. TIE Fighters don't fight TIEs. I can't remember, it was Troopers being in the storm. If the Rebels knew it was star-shaped, they'd know something was up.
Maybe, as part of its weaponry, it can have loads of spikes. Then it'll be sort of star-shaped.
Shut up, Gerald. Although that does bring me on to my next question, weaponry. We're intending to include several turbo laser towers and TIE fighter hangars in order to repel any rebel attack, but we've not really decided on the main weapon yet.
Spikes!
Would this be the bit that actually destroys the planet?
Yes, it would.
What about laser then? Like a really big one.
What about seven different layers that form together to form a giant rainbow? That way we're destroying planets, but also showing LGBT support.
Shut up, Gerald. We can't show We're the Empire, the bad guys. It's just not how we roll.
Well, I think we should be a more inclusive Empire. No one that represents all the groups.
Sounds like rebel talk to me.
Who knows, one day we might even have black stormtroopers.
I thought we already did.
No, those are black suits. I mean black people in white suits.
Moving on. Final question. Where should the weak point be?
What? Why?
Where? What?
Hello, you've reached the help desk. How may I help you?
Hiya, I was just wondering if I could lower the... Would you like to
discuss that? Sorry, can you repeat that?
I was just wondering if I could reset my account with you today.
Well, you've certainly reached the right place. So, would you mind if I asked you a couple of personal yes or no security questions just to help you with the process and confirm your identity?
Yeah, sure.
Wonderful. Are you the owner of this phone?
Yes.
Great, thank you. Did you say you wanted to reset your account?
Yes.
Are you having a nice day?
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Sorry, could you say that as a yes or no answer, please?
Oh, right. No, then.
Okay. Do you have a banana allergy?
Yeah.
Is your favourite football team Everton?
Yes.
I'll rephrase that, love. Is your favourite football team Liverpool?
Yes.
Good. Can I have your name, PIN and sword code, please?
No.
Good. Might be a bit out of line. Are you seeing anyone at the moment?
It's a little bit complicated.
Oh, yeah. Would you like to go for drinks at any point?
No.
Oh, the system isn't registering that as an answer.
Sorry. Yes, then?
Oh, great. What are you wearing?
I don't think that's an appropriate question.
Please, a yes or no answer.
No.
What is the chemical symbol for nitric oxide?
Oh, no.
What do you like to scream during sex?
Yeah.
Hotel?
Trivago.
Have you learnt your lines?
No.
Have you learnt your lines?
Yes.
Is there anything else I can do for you? Back rub? Tea? Anything like that?
Yes.
Shall I be over in a bit? Right, that's your account reset. You can thank me later.
All right, thank you.
I said later.
Bye.
But I want to ask you, Mr. Parks, and all the others with your faux outrage today, where were you when Obama, in 2011, banned any Iraqi from going into the country for 6 months? Why do I hear no criticism in this chamber or from the commissioners of Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Bahrain, and others who refuse to take a single, not one, refugee or displaced person from Syria? How can it be? How can it be put on Holocaust Day last Friday? Not a single one of you criticised the 16 countries in the world who banned Israeli Jews from even coming to their country. What is this hypocrisy? So perhaps what we need to do, Mr. President, to the use of the members, what we need to do... is to be a little bit more constructive. All of us here say we're Democrats. Well, here's the chance to prove it. Let us invite presidents to come to this European Parliament. I'm sure, as Democrats, you will all agree that we need what we need to do is have an open dialogue with the newly elected most powerful
keeps telling me. Have we shaken Neville?
I cast Petrificus Totalus on him, that frog having fuck. Don't know why everyone thinks he's a sexual god. He's a right ugly fuck.
Yeah. We're motherfucking sorcerers.
Shh, being father sucking monsters won't be enough to find the whole Proxus.
You're right, Ron.
We should go see Professor Dumbledore.
But I thought he was dead! Or worse, expelled!
you were never funny.
Yeah.
To Dumbledore!
To Dumbledore!
Yes.
Professor Dumbledore!
Charlie.
Professor.
Charlie!
So evil of Voldemort to hide the Horcrux in his trolley.
And the Dumbledore's off his trolley!
Oh, you know what's fucking funny!
Not even. Oh.
Ron, come home! Go to bed!
No, Ginny! No! No! Get off! Get off!
Oh, I'm off, sir!
Yeah, we received a call about drunk and disorderly. Oh,
just
fuck, it's you guys.
Ron, Hermione, take cover! It's the Dementors, the servants of Voldemort!
Expecto!
I can't believe you're here.
Expecto Patronum!
Yeah, call an audience. Yeah, it's those fucking kids again who think they're all wizards.
where's the wispy white?
Have you tried your other one?
It is my other one. Come on.
I can't believe I wanted to shag you.
Yep, that's right. Alright, put your hands away, you see.
Don't let him take my happiness, Harry! Don't let him take my soul!
Oh, I never had the soul to begin with, you ginger twat.
Yeah, alright. Oi, morons! You get a free pass this time, but there's someone on the line who wants to talk to you.
Ronald Weasley! Dare you steal our stash and get shit-faced! Your father is facing inquiries, Miss Dina, and it's entirely your fault! If you put another child to blind, we'll break your fucking kneecaps!
Ginny, congratulations on being a responsible one. Arthur and I are so proud. Right, come on, you bastards.
Hey! One got a howler!
I'm doomed!
Welcome back to a heavily accented Yorkshire and Saints. With us here today is Tony. Hey, Tony.
Hello!
Tony's from Doncaster, so thank you for coming all the way for what is, quite honestly, a second-rate show with a questionable human rights record. What are you going to sing for us today, Tony?
Well, recently, my grandma's dog, Timothy, died after he ran a tut lamppost.
It's a terrible accident. Accident, it's a terrible accident.
And then, I lost my pet budgerigar and a freak windmill accent accident.
So, what are you going to be singing?
And then, I totaled my car after I crashed it through tut hedge and tut field.
So what are you gonna
and be then, I hit a cow, which apparently can get you 7 points on your licence, although I don't quite
Tony! Understand. What are you going to be singing for us today?
Oh, I'm going to be singing one of my all-time favourites. I Want to Break Free by Queen.
Take it away.
I want to break free. I want to break free.
And that's all we've got time for our heavily accented Yorkshireman singing. Tune in next week when we're in Leeds. Tony's back. Brian, the scheduled actor tonight, couldn't make it because he was in an unfortunate accident with some jam, the traffic warden.
It can happen to the best of us, can't it?
Yeah.
Traffic jam.
Anyway, Tony, what are you going to be singing tonight?
Well, tonight I'm going to be attempting something a bit out of my comfort zone. I'm going to be singing ABBA's Greatest Hits Collection.
Oh, very strong choice. Oh, a little bird told me that you are not singing this the normal way. I hear that you are going to be doing this on a unicycle, on a tightrope, over a pit of tigers. Have you been practising, Tony?
Oh, yes. But unfortunately, without the tigers, you see, Peter came to take him away.
Peter, the environmental agency?
No, Peter from next door. He loves his lynx.
What, lynx, the cat?
No, the deodorant. He smells lovely.
Take it away, Tony!
Oh, you can dance. You can jump. Oh, 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 no! I've fallen into a pit!
Oh, no!
Oh, the tigers!
Oh, no, Tony!
The tigers!
Don't move, they won't be able to see you.
They're coming towards me, they can see me!
No, that's snakes.
They've got my leg!
Don't have bags, what's in the back? No, that's
my leg! Oh, God!
Don't eat yellow snow!
This is the end for me, I'm afraid!
Use protection!
Oh, good night!
Fuck! Oh, mom's going to Iceland! I think that's all we've got time for! Tune in next week for another invigorating episode where Keith here is going to be singing Donna Summer's Hot Stuff.
I want some hot stuff, baby, this evening.
While being chased. While being chased by a bear.
Want some hot stuff, baby, this evening.
Then said bear will come back and sing Hot Stuff by Donna Summers. Will Keith survive? Will Tony's dear Tony's funeral be a disaster? Will we be on air next week? Who knows? Find out next week on the Heavenly Acts of the Yorkshireman Sings!
George, darling, I'm home. Where are the children?
Afternoon, Winifred. The children are in their room.
Sleep? On a Sunday at this time?
No, they're cleaning it. How was your rally? Did you really stick it to the man?
It was fine. Well, what do you expect? I'm not about to do a song and dance about it. No, I really must go and see the children.
I wouldn't.
Why have I not?
Well, it's not that it's not clean, but they've been at it for hours. And I think some scary telekinetic shit going up there. I think they rather like it.
Well, has the nanny seen to it?
Well, she started it.
Oh. Well, then, wait a minute. We should get a new one.
Oh, no, let's not do that.
Why?
Well, for starters, they all blew away in that freak hurricane last week. And the kids have never been healthier or happier. They're guzzling down their medicine by the gallon. And we've never had more time for your rallies. She's been entertaining us, them. The children. She's been entertaining the children whilst you've been at your rallies.
You've been sleeping with her, haven't you?
What? How could you find her? Think that. How could you think that?
I knew it. I could smell her perfume on you from a mile off. Deny it, I dare you.
You think me in the neck? Look, it wasn't my fault.
Oh, do tell me, George, how is it not your fault?
Well, I'm a man, and I have needs.
You're telling me you think you don't get it enough.
I mean, you're at your rallies an awful lot.
So I'm to believe that while I've been campaigning tirelessly for women's rights, 3-hour-long rallies, you've become so lonely that you've decided to do the nanny. 3 hours, George! I was gone 3 hours! What do you see in her anyway? And don't feed me some bullshit about how she's practically perfect in every way.
Well, no, but yes, but you see her sliding up the banister? I mean, it makes things effortless.
Oh, so it's because she's magic now.
I mean, she is. Have you seen her handbag? I mean, the things she can fit in there. I'm talking whips, lube, dildos. Pastel dealers, if that. A budgerigar. One time a lamp. I mean, that's not sexual, but it's bloody impressive.
I can't believe I'm still hearing this.
Oh,
out.
Hold up. Don't think I don't know about you and that odd jobs guy. What's his name again?
Bert.
Yeah, Bert.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Ha, bollocks, you don't. That little soot on your mouth.
No, it's chalk.
Ha! I knew it! I bloody knew it! I knew I saw you in the park, jumping into those seedy lewd chalk paintings on the floor when you're supposedly out flying kites.
Ah! So you found time to spy on me, have you, in between being in between the nanny?
Oh, I mean, you're not even denying it!
I don't have to deny it. I'd never do such a thing and you know it.
What? Even if I brought up his long, dirty brush? What, has he got one for the shaft and one for the flu?
Enough. Fine. He's just got so much energy.
But his accent, the sound of it is something quite atrocious.
It's not atrocious, it's cheery and quirky. And he doesn't even have to speak. Have you seen his moves? Tap dancing his butt across the roofs of London Core. What a sight. I'd sap that any day. All day. Every day. So put that in your pipe and smoke it.
What happened to us?
I don't know, George. In between the constant stream of nannies, my campaigning for women's rights, and your job as a banker being the basic quintessential image of the patriarchy, the very thing that my friends and I are fighting against, I just think we have no real business being together. I mean, at this point, all it's doing is hurting the children, who seem to be going through some grade-A Stephen King's Carrie shit as we speak. Well, don't you have anything to say to make this better? Anything?
Oh. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
No, George. That did fuck all. Caught wind of a possible return of the famous Bill and Ted starring Keanu Reeves, and you're the one who was also in Bill and Ted starring Keanu Reeves. And so we've decided to welcome its return with a silly little sketch of our own along the same kind of lines, if maybe they'd invited some of the less savory characters from history.
Hello! Yeah! Oh, let's get drunk with these colorful characters from history!
That's gonna be so cool for... Is that Hitler?
Yeah, maybe not talk to him.
Hey! Is that Pol Pot?
Oh my god, did you say Pol Pot, the winner of Britain's Got Talent Season 1? That Pol Pot?
No, the Cambodian dictator, bro!
Murdoch turns of his own people!
Oh! No, that's not too bad, then.
Is that Marie Antoinette by the snacks?
Oh my god, she's bodacious!
So bodacious, bro!
Hey, Marie! Got any buns, girl? Look for a little bread, baby? Yeah.
Why do people keep asking that? I've got all these cakes, not anybody wants it! Bloody bread!
She's a bit Welsh.
I don't understand you people!
Bro!
Well,
what is it with her?
I think she lost her head and freaked.
So bad. Yeah, sorry.
Oh my god, look! It's Guy Fawkes bringing in the beer!
And he's got a whole freaking keg, son!
What is in there, mate?
Beer.
What kind of beer, bro?
Lager. Where's your basement?
Cheers!
Cheers!
Wait.
What? Shit. Huh?
It's Guy Fawkes, bro.
Yeah?
He's taking a keg into the basement.
Oh my god, I'm same wavelength. He's gonna drink the whole thing!
Bro!
Hello. I'm Sarah Jane Mee. Welcome to Sky News. Today the sky is blue. Later it'll go a slightly darker shade of blue. At night it will look black, but it's still blue. In the morning it will gradually become a brighter shade of blue. This is what happens every day. I don't know how we're still on the air. Say something about the observational skills of the human race, I suppose. Now on to the Sky News, where you are.
Hi, I'm Gamal Fambali, and welcome to your local Sky News. Today, the sky is actually kind of red. This is because of the sun. But it is nothing to worry about. It is only due to the angle of the sun in the sky. You know, it looks kind of... Back to the Sky News around the world.
Hello, welcome back. I'm Sarah Jane Mee. The sky is still blue. Depends where you are in the world. Depends on your point of view. Now for Sky News Entertainment with Anna Botting.
This is Sky News Entertainment. Mr. Blue Sky is a pretty good song.
Thanks, Anna. That's the end of the Sky News for today. Good night.
Hello everyone, I'm Frank.
Hi, Frank.
Hi, Frank.
I guess it all started when I left the army. I found myself displaced from society with no home to go to.
It's okay.
So I started using.
It's okay, Frank. Go on.
Thank you, Dr. Blue. The heroin, it took over my life before I really had a chance to catch hold myself. My wife died shortly after my daughter started selling her body.
That's truly harrowing, mate. Great story. Now, I see some old faces here, some new ones. Who'd like to talk next?
I just want to say thanks to Frank for being so open with us all.
Yeah, thanks, Frank. Hi, Josie.
Hi, my name's Josie.
Hi, Josie.
And I'm an addict. It's the taste that got me hooked. I'm so ashamed. I'm just using it everywhere. My kids' parents' evenings have even started doing it.
It's okay, Josie. Go on.
It's just... Again, it's the hard part, but once I've got my finger up there, and I've like wiggled it round for a bit, I found a big, soft, chunky one.
There's nothing more satisfying than chowing down on a good bit of snot.
Truly, Harry, great, great job, Josie. Now, these bad habits that you all share can make you feel alienated from society. So I want you to understand that this is a safe space. You feel nothing to be ashamed of.
I guess it's me. I'm Bobby.
Bobby.
I'm an addict. I mean, it's been 6 months ago since I started sniffing the pavement.
But hold on, what?
No, Frank. This is your first time here, but you've got to understand. Everyone's got their bad habits.
Bad habits? How the hell is smelling pavement and eating boogies even on the same level as my crippling heroin addiction?
Now, Frank, this is a safe space.
A safe space? This is kick. My life is ruined. I've lost my wife, my house, my daughter, my dog, my kittens. It's true. It's a fucking joke! I'm done!
Frank, is okay to cry? Did he just
pick his ear?
It's fucking disgusting.
I'm off to prom, Daddy! Bye!
Hold your horses! I want a quick chat with you before you go.
But Daddy!
Now hold your ponies, love. It's because I care about you. Now, there are a few things I want you to take with you before you go, just to be on the safe side. Unlike your mother and I at our prom night. So here are my pants and some change for parking.
Oh, thanks, Daddy. Bye!
Hold your mules. There's more.
What are you going to give me?
I'm ready.
Yeah,
I'm ready. Now, here's a portable phone charger for your phone, for emergencies only. Also, here's your phone, for emergencies only. Also, I'm in all night, so feel free to call any time. Oh, like, as long as it's not from 10 till about 10 past, because that's Daddy's time, money, and he wants to be alone.
Thanks, Daddy. You think of everything. But I've got to go now. Brad will be here any minute.
Hold your, falls? Now, I know you kids like to have fun. And, I know boys today can be quite forward. So, if they start getting a little eyeballsy, here's some pepper spray. And if they start getting a bit handsy, here's a baseball bat. And if they really don't get the message, here's a gun. Now, remember what Daddy taught you? Two in the balls, one in the heart,
and one in the head.
Oh, I'm so proud.
Oh, Daddy, you're embarrassing me.
No, I know. You're free to go after just a little walk. Now, I know you kids like to have fun, and if you're anything like your mother, you'll be needing this before long. Trust me, dear, you'll need it to keep your energy up. And bananas are a great source of potassium. Remember what else I taught you? A banana a day keeps hypokalemia away.
Daddy, you're the weirdest.
I try.
Oh, Brad's here now.
No. The young gentleman caller. Now, before you go, here's some condoms and some hand sanitizer. You do not want to know where she's been.
It's happening again, because the jokes were so funny the first time.
Your plan is slowly crumbling.
How may I ask?
Well, apart from your cut price, construction work is shoddy work. The shop has risen.
The accents are better. And nothing will stop the tide.
And all its stock is Everton merchandise.
So scum!
From the creators of Liverpool 2. Everton 3.
Are you sitting comfortably?
Oh.
Detective Marlborough's journal. January 12th, 2017. Tonight, a camel died. Pavement's wet like the brim of my hat. Chest warm like my cigarette. I put it out on the lid of a trash can and throw it in the opening. The trash can screams. Turns out it was a homeless man. Don't ask. I meet my trusty sidekick, Constable Starling.
Detective Marlborough. Detective Starling.
We found the crime scene.
Ah, look what's happened here. Cigarette royalty. The company did so much for the community. The Camel Gold snuffed out. This could mean a sustained attack on cigarettes is imminent. First, non-branded packaging. Now this.
Are you Detective Starling of Marlborough?
Who wants to know?
Me. I did just ask.
What do you know about what happened here?
Well, I'm the cleaner here. So I came up to do the flat and here he was, dead. And there was a shadowy figure standing over the body. And then he was gone in a puff of smoke.
We're cigarettes. We all create puffs of smoke.
No, this was different. It was pure white and so big.
Gigantic white clouds. This could mean only one thing.
Detective Marlborough's journal, January 17th, 2017. There is only one criminal that could be possibly behind this crime. A dangerous one at that. The most dangerous kind are the ones that think they're doing good. After days of tracking, following leads, eating donuts, drinking coffee, and smoking cigarettes across, we tracked down our caped crusader. Or should I say,
the vape crusader!
Oh, Maro Sterling! Maybe you good. My shop on every high street, my flavors are endless. Time budget is negligible, and my pricing is competitive. They've even started stocking my product in the newspaper. News agents now. What can you hope to achieve?
We hope to stop you. It's kind of why we tracked you down here and confronted you. It's almost as if this parody noir genre asks a lot of unnecessary questions that could be easily answered.
Yeah.
Still doesn't justify corporate murder.
And what's wrong with getting rid of another cancerous capitalist? I contain no cancers. Who would want to buy you?
There's no scientific backing for that statement! You can contain just as many harmful chemicals!
Cool it, Starling! It's all in fact, Miss Boyd. Face it.
At least we don't rely on potentially harmful batteries, atomizers, and unregulated modifications.
At least they can be mechanically fixed. Unlike cancer.
Damn it!
That still doesn't justify selling it to the kids as well!
Why do you think I come in so many different flavors?
The kiddies love my strawberry burst.
Now who's the capitalist?
I never claimed events being a capitalist. My only claim was not being cancerous.
We're gonna stop you. Oh. A final showdown.
Your time has passed, old man. I'll stub you out. What can you hope to achieve?
We're good enough to find you.
Oh, well, good luck finding me again.
No! Citrus explosion! My least favorite flavor!
A slightly healthier alternative!
Detective Marlborough's journal, January 18th, 2017. He's taken over. His product is all over the streets, inside those poor kids. But there will come a day when kids will once again feel the warm clasp of tar on their bronchioles. And the vape crusader will be put away for what he's done. A new dawn will come when someone asks, bro, do you even vape? And we can proudly say we're sucking on our decent hard oil death sticks. No sorry, no sorry, we don't.
Before we go any further, I just wanted to say that I think you'll find this next property is absolutely brimming with character. It's a lovely little standalone renovation, isolated from the busy main road by those beech trees we passed on the way in.
Oh, right.
Door's a little stiff, just needs a bit of tender, loving care.
Here we are, it's a spacious little number. Classic Gothic Victorian architecture, if a little rough around the edges. As we can see up here, we have some barewood ceiling beams with ornaments attached. There's plenty of character there.
I love barewood ceiling beams.
Here we can move over here, we can see a window situated inside the building. Very unusual for this type of property. Has plenty of character, don't you agree?
Looks a bit broken glassy.
Well, how else do you think all the character got there? Well, watch you don't step on that bit of character on the floor. The dog must have left it there.
Oh my god, I love dogs. Did the last owners have one?
No. No pets allowed on the premises, I'm afraid.
Oh.
If we can move swiftly down to the basement.
Oh, oh. Oh my god. Are you a serial killer?
What? Shabby.
No, like, yeah, a serial killer. I can't believe I didn't realize it before me, duh. It's really obvious when you think about it. I mean, like, the overalls, the weird laugh.
Abby, you can't keep accusing every person we meet in a professional capacity as a serial killer just because of the way they look and the way they talk. It's like Timmy's swimming teacher all over again.
But it explains so much. Like how the last two houses he showed us weren't even houses at all, you remember. One was just a renovated mental hospital, and the other an abandoned amusement park.
I thought you'd like that one.
Oh, no, no, I still do. Oh, every time he says the word character, he's clearly referring to something that's covered in blood. The smashed glass, the meat hooks.
Ornaments.
The meat hook ornaments on the barewood ceiling beams. Oh, and also the way he's menacingly holding that baseball bat behind you.
Right, you're right this time. What gives?
All right, you got me. I'm a serial killer.
Ha!
I'm sorry. I just really need to sell this house and the amusement park and the mental hospital. Could we please just go down to the basement so I can finish the tour? It's just, I've worked really hard on this and it'll mean so much to me.
Oh, well, I still want to see it. You know, can we just take a quick look?
I still prefer the amusement park, but okay.
Excellent. Now, I recently had one of the neighbours down here. Do you know Mr. Patel from number 81? He was quite the character. And now there's character everywhere. Okay, darling. I'm going to throw a dart at this map, and wherever it lands, that's where we'll go on holiday. Oh,
capital idea, Poppet. Well, anywhere will be better than last year's holiday to Torquay.
Absolutely. Here we go.
Okay.
Hey.
Torquay.
How?
Well, you always had excellent aim, darling.
Touché. I'll try again.
Right.
What? No. Hey.
Death Valley.
Hottest place on earth, not happening. I'll try again.
The Russian research station in Vostok, Antarctica.
Coldest place on earth, not happening. New rule, it needs to be a place where humans can survive.
Tip top. Wolverhampton.
It needs to be a place where humans can survive. That's original.
The Pacific Ocean.
Unworkable.
The Pacific Ocean.
My views are unchanged.
The Pacific Ocean.
Well, I suppose this is to be expected when it comes to the third of the planet!
Belgium.
Fuck off!
Portugal.
Boring!
Australia.
Fucking hate spiders!
Djibouti.
Never heard of it!
The Pacific Ocean.
Right, we'll pack it into a lovely fuck!